Hello friends, in this video I am going to explain you how you can write a program to merge two linked lists by placing the data in the second linked list after the data of the first linked list. Means suppose if we have this linked list as first linked list, this B as the second linked list. You can see that in our first linked list A, we have three nodes, means three data are there. In the second linked list, means B, we have four nodes. Now the purpose of the program is that just after the end of this first linked list, we should come to the second. Means from here, our program should come to this particular node. And after this particular node, we have this next is at 1100, then next node is at 1200, next is at 1300. So if we start with head 1, then from head 1 we will go to 200, from 200 we will go to 300, from 300 we will go to 400, and if we put this 1000 over here, then from 400 we will go to 1000, from 1000 we will go to 1100, from 1100 we will go to 1200, 1200 see, we are going to go to 1300, and at 1300 we have a null, so we will stop over here. So it means to merge these two linked list, we just have to place this 1000 over here, and to place this 1000 over here, our first steps is to locate the address of this last node of the first linked list. So if we get the address of this last node, let it be PTR. So if it is PTR, then simply by writing PTR next equals to head 2. If we write this, then simply this statement is going to put 1000 over here. 1000 over here. And if we put 1000 over here, then after this last node, we are going to come to the first node of the second linked list. So this is all we need to do. So let me show you how we can write a program, C program for this. So in the starting over here, I first create this structure, and our structure, it contains two members, int data, in which we are going to store the information, and the pointer to the next node. And using typedef, I rename my struct node as node. Now in the main program, I declare some variables like head1 for the first linked list. I initialize it as null. Then head2 for the second linked list. I initialize it as null. Then some pointer like new node, ptr. This new node will help us to create a new node. This ptr will help us to locate the last node of the head 1 of the first linked list. This we do not need, so I will remove it. Apart from that, we use this integer variables I for the loop and A and NB to get the total number of nodes that will be there in linked list A and linked list B. So first of all, because like when we start a program, in the starting we do not have any data in the linked list. So because our head 1 and head 2, they are null. So first of all, we need to enter the data. So to enter the data in linked list A, I ask the user to enter the number of nodes in the linked list. So whatever number that user is going to enter, that I scan in NA, in variable NA. And then I start a loop from 0 to N. So with this loop, I will be able to ask user to enter the value for each and every node of the linked list A. So inside the for loop, first I create a new node. I ask the compiler to allocate a memory for the new node, and the starting address of that new memory that is allocated, I store it in new node. Then I ask the user to enter data for the first linked list. So whatever value user is going to enter, that will be assigned to new node data. So whatever the node which we just created, in that we assign the value to that. and then new note next is head 1. Over here, like with this algorithm, we are just inserting a note at the beginning of the linklist. So we are not going into much detail of it because our focus area is merging. And if you have any doubt regarding this, so I would like to refer you to go to the YouTube video in which I have explained how to insert a node at the beginning of the linklist. Okay, so similarly, we enter the values in the linklist B. Now once we insert all these details, then over here I print. Over here I print the data in the linklist A. Whatever data is there, I just print that. Similarly, we print the data of the over here. We print the data of linklist B, right? And then we come to the merging part. So let me show you how this program is going to work with the help of the table. So this is our code. So if I draw the table, so our first step is ptr equals to head 1. So ptr equals to head 1. Head 1 is 200. So I put 200 over here. Then next is ptr next. We are checking a condition. Ptr next not equals to null. So ptr next is our ptr next. It is 200 next is 300. So it is 300, and since 300 is not equals to null, so condition is true. This condition is true, so we will execute this. So updated value of ptr, it will be ptr next, means it will be 300. Now again we will go back to while loop, and again we will check if ptr next is not equals to null. What is ptr next? Ptr is 300, so ptr next, it will be this 400. So it will be 400. Now again we will check if this condition is true. Since ptr next is 400 and it is not null, so it means that this condition is true. Since condition is true, so we are going to update the value of ptr. So new value of ptr, it will be ptr next, means it will be 400. Previously it was 300, so 300 next is 400. So our next value of ptr, it will be 400. After this, again we will go to the condition. Again we will check if ptr next, it is null. 400 next is this null. So now the condition becomes false, because ptr next, it is null, and null not equals to null, the statement is false, right? So this condition of the while loop, it becomes false, and since it becomes false, so we are not going to go inside the while loop, and we will come out of the while loop. And when we come outside the while loop, we are going to execute this ptr next. Now ptr is 400, so 400 next means we are over here. So this value, it is equals to head 2. Head 2 is 1000. So over here we are going to put 1000, and once we put this 1000, then after this node 400, we will come to this particular node. So by writing this 1000 over here, we are able to link this node at 400 with the link at 1000. And once we linked it, then it means that we linked the linked list A and B together. Okay, so coming back to the program, over here we just do this merging part. And after the merging, we print the merged linked list. Right? So to print that merged linked list, again I initialize the ptr as head 1, because the starting address of the merged linked list, it is our head 1. Okay, so I print the data, and then it is the end of the program. So now if I run this program, so you can see that over here in the output screen, it is asking me to enter the number of nodes in the linked list. So suppose if I enter 3, and then it is asking me enter data 3 of the first linked list. So suppose if I enter 1, then enter data 2 of the first linked list. So let me enter 2. Enter data 1 of the first linked list. Means we need to enter the data of the first linked list. First node over here. So let me enter 3. So after this, it is asking me to enter the number of nodes in the linked list view. So let me enter 5. So it is asking me to enter data of the fifth node of the second linked list. So let me enter 9. Enter data 4 of the second linked list, 8. Then 7. Then 6. Then 5. So I entered this, and as soon as I entered this, first it displayed the data of the linked list A. We entered 3, 2, 1. You can see that data 3 of the first linked list is 1. We entered 1. So you, over here we have 1. Then we entered 2. And data 1 of the first linked list, it is 3. So it is 3 over here. Similarly, whatever value that we entered for linked list B, that is over here, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then data in the merged linked list, it is 3 to 1, means data of linked list A followed by data of linked list, right? So in this way, you can see that we are able to merge the two linked lists. So with this, I end this video. If you have any doubt, you can write it in the comment box, and do subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.